So I gotta rewrite or resketch a new page that the client wants that's based on what a reporter does. I've printed out a bunch of photographs, and how I typically will do this is lay out all the photographs and then visualize what my page is gonna look like. So I create a box that's roughly the page of the book, and then I wanna visualize with a quick sketch the process of a reporter writing a story. And then I want to do something with a cameraman shooting another reporter as they tell a story. And I want to end with perhaps a reporter, like maybe asking a question. Some of the process here, I'm developing the idea more in detail as I'm sketching it out. So he'll kind of be writing or about to ask a question at a press conference. And then I'm gonna throw some of a New York scene. So that's my idea, roughly. And so I'm gonna take that thumbnail sketch, or rough sketch, tape it to my illustration board. Actually, I'm gonna put it on my easel initially. Because the next thing I wanna do is, one thing, me as a creative person, I'm always distracted by a white canvas or a white board. So the very first thing I need to do is to have my paints all open and ready to go. And now I'm just gonna grab my big, trusty big brush and start adding color. Based on my sketch, I wanna kind of visualize what I see or how I'm gonna use color. So there may appear to be some randomness to it, and it really is some, but where I know I'm gonna be involved with a lot of painting. A certain area. So the squinting of the eyes is to simplify the form in front of me. So whether I'm doing detail or I just want to see and visualize what a background looks like, I want to squint so that I simplify it and I don't see all the brush strokes. I do want the brush strokes to be there, but when my eyes are wide open, I see too much. What I do next is I want this stuff to dry. So I try to lay it flat. So what I'm gonna do next is literally take one of the boards that has dried over the weekend. Based on the sketch, and the photograph reference that's down here, and I think I want to pull at least one Bronx scene. And so I literally will do a lot of the actual sketching on the canvas. Using a small brush and a photo reference that I pull from everywhere, I'm gonna start laying out that page that I just sketched up. I've always had a love of children's books, and the one that has affected me and affected many people is Israel Jack Keys, A Snowy Day. And what inspired me so much about that particular book was that it was the first time I saw myself in a children's book, and it wasn't a derogatory image of a black child. I knew somehow I wanted to be involved in creating that story, that narrative. And so having an opportunity to do it once, I fell in love with it and knew it was something I wanted to not dedicate my time to, but definitely spend more time doing. And I've just been blessed to be given some opportunities to do some really great assignments. And each one gets me hooked even further into trying to pursue that dream. So what you can see right now, I'm really just blocking in the shapes of the figures. And once I think I have enough information there to be comfortable with, what I do next is, said there were certain scenes that I wanted to add. So I love the patterns and everything that's going on. In particular, this mural, this part of Zarrell's bakery. So I want to incorporate that in part of her design, because the overall theme in the book is also the beauty of the Bronx that a lot of times people don't see. And so, of course, in a lot of major urban areas, the beauty comes in the graffiti. And so it's very focused on the beauty of the art of writing as well as art expression itself. And so I want to kind of layer that story in the overall layout. So what I'm gonna do, and what I'll typically do when I get this far, on the layout, is I'll take a photograph of it and take it home and look at it with a fresh eye after a few hours before I come back to the studio and do anything more with it. I'm happy with what I've laid out.